today we'll be discussing about the knowledge representation in artificial intelligence. This is the main concept which is used to impart knowledge into robotic agents. So let's get started. So there are two logics in knowledge representation, that is the propositional logic as well as the predicate logic. This propositional logic is also called as the Boolean logic. It is also called as the PL. Now this Boolean logic, it basically consists of either true or false statements. And so it is a basically plain text or any declarative language used for representing this logic. Next is a predicate logic, also called as the first order predicate logic. It has got three main types: first argument, second argument, as well as the third arguments. So we will be covering that in our example section. So to get a brief idea about predicate knowledge is logic is that predicate logic is a superset, or it can be considered as a superset of propositional logic. So what all things which comes under propositional logic is segregated into predicate logic. So let's get started. So here is one example. Suppose I want to represent it is humid. For example, it is given three statements. It is humid. And if it is humid, then it is hot. And one more is there. If it is hot and humid, then it will rain. Now, for humid, now you have to see the object if it is humid. Now, for this statement, for basically humid, we'll assign P. Means P represent it is humid. Now, let us go to the second statement. If it is humid, then it is hot. Now, the statement says that if it is humid, that is, if it is P, then it is hot. So, for hot, we'll represent Q. So, the statement basically tells that if it is humid, that is, if it is P, arrow, then it is hot. Now, this arrow represents then. So, if it is humid, then it is hot. Next, if it is hot as well as humid, then it will rain. First is hot, that is Q, and humid, that is P, then it will rain. That is, for rain, we'll give R. So, basically, it goes like this. Q as well as P gives R. Now, the statement tells that it should be hot as well as humid for it to rain. So, Q and P gives rise to R. So, this is what is the propositional logic. So, next is the predicate logic. So, to go with predicate logic, there are three main types of predicate logic. Now, first is a single argument predicate, means only one argument would be there. Means that, for example, consider the chalk is white. Now, in this, if you go by the basic English, means you can understand that the chalk is a noun and white is an adjective. So, while representing in predicate logic, or when you will be converting into logic, you will be writing like white means the thing is white, the object is white. So the object would be chalk, means the chalk is white. So this gives rise to single argument, means only one argument is there, that is chalk. So chalk is our argument. Next is the two argument predicate. Now, in this, the statement would be Abhay is a friend of Ajay. Now, in this, friend would be the describing thing, or this basically the connecting link between Abhay and Ajay. So, we'll be writing friend in bracket Abhay, comma Ajay. Means in this two arguments are there, so that's why it is a two argument predicate, and in this one argument is there, so it is a single argument. Next we have three argument predicates. Now in this it will be like Abhay gave a book to Ajay. So in this, give will be the connecting link. Means Abhay gave a book to Ajay. Abhay is a noun, book is also a noun, Ajay is also a noun. So we'll be writing like gave, and first it will be Abhay, then comma, book, and Ajay. So when you read this, it is like Abhay gave a book to Ajay. So in this, basically three parameters are there, so that's why it is a three argument predicate. So argument basically it includes the noun that is there in the sentence. So this is the knowledge representation. So hope you enjoyed this video. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. Thanks for watching this video.